Hello everybody, welcome to this video on Unacademy. Today I would be talking to you all about anthropology strategy for UPSC civil services examination, and this video is presented to you by me, Lakshmi. This is a brief introduction about myself. I have secured All India rank 45 in the civil services examination and All India rank 50 in the Indian Forest Services examination 2018. So I will just tell you about what this video is actually going to be like. So I will be talking to you about anthropology. So here I would be telling you all about how to write answers and how to go about the subject. Further, in my next video, I will also be talking to you all about my book list that I used for my anthropology preparation. And yes, this year I've also secured highest marks in anthropology. I have secured 362 marks in the examination. So before I actually start off, I have a small announcement to make. That is, I would be teaching live on Unacademy Plus platform. And here I would be handling on various courses related to general studies preparation for civil services mains examination. I would be an educator on this platform for the next 3 months until my training begins in the month of August. Okay. So, however, by subscribing to my course on Unacademy, apart from my course, you would also be given access to various other courses on the platform. Okay, and these courses are designed in a very, very comprehensive manner such that you are able to tackle every stage of the examination adequately, be it prelims or mains or even interview. Okay, such as this course on economy is by Mrunal Sir. And we have another one on international relations and internal security by Ayush. Then these are some of the best educators on the platform. And yes, Roman Seni would also be taking courses related to general studies as well as essay and answer writing. Okay. So apart from these courses, we also have test series. Okay. One is related to general studies and the other one is related to CSAT. So as you can see, these tests are held on a weekly basis. So every week you would be able to evaluate yourself and to see as to where you stand in the preparation until next prelims. Okay. So all you need to do is to subscribe to Unacademy Plus, and using my referral code, that is Lakshmi, you can also avail a 10% discount. So please remember to subscribe to Unacademy Plus platform, and here I would be teaching on various topics related to general studies preparation, and by using my name, okay, as a referral code, you can also get access to courses by various other educators on the platform and get a 10% discount on your annual Unacademy Plus subscription. Okay, so now let's get started. So what is anthropology? So before we actually dive into the subject and you decide whether to take anthropology or not, it's very important to know what is anthropology, right? So anthropos, and you can divide anthropology into anthropos and logos. So anthropos means man and logos means study. So it is a scientific study of origin of man, how we evolved and how we relate to each other both within and outside our culture. Okay, so this man here just doesn't mean Homo sapiens, or we are Homo sapiens sapiens. It just doesn't mean us. It is right from Australopithecus to Homo sapiens, how man has evolved and the related biological as well as cultural changes. Okay. So this is the broad scope of the discipline. First, we have physical anthro, archaeological anthropology. Then we have linguistics, and we also have socio-cultural anthropology. Okay, so in physical anthropology, these are the major disciplines, but in our subject, when we restrict ourselves to civil services, we would be doing on primatology, human genetics, demography, growth and development, and adaptation. This would be a part of applied anthro. Okay, And with related to archaeology, you are supposed to know prehistoric cultures, that is the cultures even before we had any written records. So apart from this, in historical, we'll also have Paleolithic, okay, Mesolithic, Neolithic and Chalcolithic and Iron Age cultures. And this must be read both with respect to India as well as the world. Okay. In linguistics, this forms a very small part of a study for civil services examination, and we would be largely concentrating on sociolinguistics. Okay. In sociocultural anthropology, kinship, applied, gender, political, religion, economic, these are some of the important concepts that you're supposed to know, because it is here that anthropological theories have evolved. So we have different works which are done by thinkers like Malinowski, Radcliffe Brown, etc. And their works are important when you quote answers on your paper with respect to these topics. Okay. And lastly, from all these four disciplines, we have applied anthro. So what is applied anthro? So here we would be studying about the theoretical aspects, and when we use our anthropological knowledge to gather further information and to make human life even more easy, we use that in anthropological, applied anthropology. And we also have another related discipline called as action anthropology, wherein we have good amount of work done in India by people like L.P. Vidyarthi, etc. Okay, so this is the scope of the discipline. So once I've told you this, you may actually feel the scope is really huge. So can I do this in 3 months or 4 months? Do I need a specialist knowledge, or is a generalist understanding sufficient, right? So I will just tell you about my background so that you are able to decide whether you should take anthropology as an optional or not. Okay, so this is my background. I'm an engineer by graduation. Okay, but however, this year I've scored 362 marks in anthropology. So I decided to take anthropology as an optional in sometime in January, and I spent around 5 months exclusively for this preparation. Okay, but I did not take any formal coaching. That was only because I did not have enough time. But in my previous mains, my optional was sociology, and since I had sound knowledge and I was familiar with the thinkers there, it took me less time. But however, if you are a first timer, okay, I would tell you that you must spend around 6 to 8 months, because conceptual clarity is very, very important to score good marks. Okay. And further, I had also enrolled for MA anthropology at IGNU. Okay. And I spent a lot of time with the professors at the university, correcting my answers and all that. So if you are also able to get that amount of guidance, it would be really good. Okay. So now let's get started as to how to write answers in anthropology. Okay. So first thing, you should know that anthropology, unlike sociology, it is not completely a humanities-based discipline. Okay. Here we have right amount of mixture of both humanities as well as science. So in science, it is largely about biological evolution of man. Okay. It's largely about biological evolution of man. So when you're writing answers in anthropology, it becomes very, very crucial to give justice to both the aspects. Otherwise, if it is one-sided, it would look really, really incomplete. Okay. So I'm just giving you an example. If at all, there's a question on Darwin's theory. Okay. So what I would do is I would write the biological reasons for the cause of mutation and about Darwin's theory, etc. And at the end, I would also write about its anthropological implications. So, you know, if you also know similar examples wherein you can write biological as well as sociological implications, do comment below so that I'll also know whether you're thinking on the similar lines. Okay. And next is about diagrams. Diagrams are very, very crucial. So if you see an answer paper, and because it is said that if you draw one diagram, it can explain 1,000 words, provided you draw it really neatly. So to know where you get diagrams, how do you draw them, you can also refer to this book by Vivek Basme, sir. He has a lot of diagrams, so you can incorporate them in your answers. Okay. So firstly, remember that there should, it, since anthropology has a right mixture of both humanities as well as science, you need to do justice to both while you're writing an answer. Then use diagrams. Next is case studies and examples. Okay, these are a must, but however, we cannot find case studies for every topic which is there. So for whatever topic you can, okay, do find them and then quote them in your answers. Do not just keep them away. So here, you can also use new developments and research work. Because a lot of people might not Google and find out what research work is actually happening in anthropology. But if you are able to do it, it will certainly add an edge over others. Next, I will just give you an example so that you are able to think how to get case studies. Okay, it can be very trivial also, like this one. So imagine they are asking me a question on Human Genome Project. Okay, so what I would do is I will write about Human Genome Project and the entire whatever we've read in our books. And at the end, I would add my own thoughts. I would say that this germline editing, okay, which is a part of Human Genome Project, it could cause a end to human race. Why? Because we could start developing designer babies. Okay, this would be against the laws of nature. Okay, you can do that. Next, presentation. Okay, so presentation differs from each individual to the other. So it depends on you as to how do you want to make your answers look. So I would suggest, instead of writing all the 20 answers in a monotonous fashion, what you can do is actually switch between paragraph and point-wise format so that you are able to answer as per the demand of the question. Okay, so I used to also use a pencil wherever possible to draw diagrams. But if you can draw really beautiful diagrams with pen and label them properly, you can do that too. Next is flowcharts. Okay, so just imagine they're asking a question about biological evolution. Okay, so what I can do is I will just write about from hypothalamus, what are the changes which what are the changes which took place, and then what are the related changes, what are the changes which took place in female reproductive system. I would just draw a flowchart. So you can do that and make your answers look even more appealing, okay? And lastly, in the conclusion of an answer, what you can do is you can summarize it, okay? And then maybe in a sentence or two, write beautifully what you've understood in the whole question. Okay, so since I've told you how to write answers using flowcharts, presentation should be really good, use case studies, examples, now I'll tell you about the general structure of an answer. So we know it should be introduction. So introduction is generally what you understand in the question. Okay, then about body, here you can use thinkers and their ideas. You can draw diagrams, flowcharts, side heads. If they're asking you a question based on comparison, you can also draw tabular column like this. And then say what do you mean, you can differentiate easily. And conclusion, you just need to summarize, but conclusion is very important in an answer too. Okay, so there are a lot of things to memorize in anthropology, especially archaeological anthropology, and also some amount of physical anthropology, especially if you're from a non-medical background like me. You would have to spend a lot of time in memorizing things. So I would tell you that if you have 3 or 4 months before mains, you need to revise anthropology, especially the physical and the archaeology part, maybe once in a week or twice in a week. It's very, very essential. Okay, and I would say, If you have one takeaway from this video, I think it would be this, okay? It takes time to understand, but trust me, if you've understood this, you can definitely score 300 plus in the subject, okay? It's very simple. You need to answer as per the demand of the question, okay? This, one of my senior told me this, that every answer is an emotion. Okay, it is actually an emotion which needs to be conveyed to the examiner. You need to put down what you feel in an answer paper. If you are able to do that and not just vomit whatever you know, I can assure you that you will definitely cross 300 in an anthropology or even in a GS paper. 100, crossing 100 would be really, really easy. Okay, since now we've seen how to write answers in anthropology, we'll go to the next section, that is, how do I approach anthropology as a subject. So I've told you that the subject is quite vast, especially paper, if they've given me around 1 week's time. This year we had 1 week time before mains, and I spent around 4.5 days just on paper one. That's how voluminous it is, and it's really volatile too. So you need to spend a lot of time going back and revising often so that it would be easier for you in the last 1 week before the exam, okay? But if you have to decide whether I should choose anthropology or sociology or some other optional, the best way is to read this book. Okay, it's a book by Ember and Ember. This book is not important for the examination perspective from end to end, but it would give you a clear idea about the scope of the discipline. Okay, so you will know what who are the thinkers, what are their ideas, what is the scope of the discipline. So if anybody has read, you know, Ember and Ember, you can also post them below and tell others how useful it is. And we can also see if we can do lessons on Ember and Ember. Okay, next is to work smartly. What do you mean by work smartly? Because every topper will definitely tell you work smart, work smart. So what do they actually mean? They actually mean that you have so many coaching institutes today that it is not necessary for you to do everything from the start. Okay, so we have so many resources online. For example, for anthropology, we have very good coaching materials. We have topper's notes, we have test papers, we have Telegram groups and whatnot, right? So what I did was I just used them effectively. So that reduced my time and I spent more time on revision. Okay, so I used to make a combined notes of this and then revise only them repeatedly. So therefore, the content is already available, right? So you do not have to start from the scratch. Instead, invest time on how you can make things better on your presentation, etc. Next, be exam oriented. What do I mean by be exam oriented? See, you can watch a lot of videos online, even take notes, write down, use the internet the way you want. And then maybe for thinkers, you can refer to Alabama University or do whatever. But at the end, you should know that you're doing that only to get conceptual clarity. After you get conceptual clarity and you put down whatever you know in your own words, stick only to that. Do not change your strategy often. Do not read new books often. Okay, be exam oriented, because after all, you know that UPSC will be given 2 sheets. How many of our books you read, how many of our videos you watch, how much can you fill here? It's going to be very limited, right? So keep your resources limited and do only them repeatedly. Okay, then so next, a lot of you will be asking me about good sources to refer for current affairs and materials for anthropology. So one is Rajya Sabha TV videos. Okay, the best part about Rajya Sabha TV videos here is there's an episode called Maybe Bharat. Okay, here they take every tribe. Okay, and they discuss maybe in half an hour about their lifestyle, about their practices, etc. So why I am advising you to watch that is not because you can write that directly in your exam. The thing is, you will develop an interest for the tribes. You will know how they live. That will strike a kind of curiosity. You will know something more than the others. And who knows, you might use them even in an answer somewhere. So that's why you can use them in an essay. You know, it is really nice to know how they live while we live like this. So you can use them there. Then Hindu articles on page 18, okay, of the Hindu life page. There you find something related to Neanderthal man or some fossil discovery. You can write them down and quote them in your answers. Okay, and I also refer to articles or a case study which was provided by Sachin Gupta sir, that is available on the internet, so you can check that. And reports on the website of Ministry of Tribal Affairs. Do not restrict yourself only to Kaka committee report. Okay, this everybody would read. If you read other reports too, you will develop different, you can get different examples and quote different ideas. Okay, and I also refer to this course on Coursera related to contemporary happenings in the fields of anthropology. This is done by few anthropologists themselves, but then this course isn't available anymore. So in case you are able to find something similar on the internet, you can use them as well. Okay, further, to understand thinkers, you know, in anthropology, the really tough part is paper 1, chapter 6. Because this has the entire thinkers. And we generally have this tendency that if there are 11 thinkers, we do the first three really well and we leave the rest. So we need to develop an interest to understand their ideas. So what I can suggest is go through their documentaries as well as the summaries. So example, about Samoan Islands, we have documentaries by Margaret Mead. Okay. Then we also have lot of documentaries about Malinowski. So you can actually watch them. They are available on BBC. Okay. And you can also go at least through the synopsis of their books so that you are able to get their ideas. One, what happens if you get their thoughts and ideas perfectly is that you will be able to use their thoughts with ease in your answers. So that's the bigger advantage. And I told you, you need to develop an interest for tribals. Why? Because in paper 2, we have a whole section on tribal anthropology. So if you do not have interest for tribals and you are not able to get their customary practices, their traditions, etc. right, it would be very difficult to score good marks in paper 2. So for example, it can be very trivial. You know, what you watch on TV, you need not by heart every tribes in India or what are the practices, what are the religion or what are they called, etc. See, when I went to BR Hills in Karnataka, I know that the Soligas tribes are doing very good with the honey collection and their entrepreneurship skill has also improved. So I wrote that as an example in my answer. So anything, you know, this happens when you watch something on TV. That's why I told you to watch the video on Rajya Sabha TV. And if somebody has already watched such videos, you can also post in the comment section below and the link so that others are also able to get benefited by the same. Lastly, this is another important thing, interlinking. Okay. This can happen only if you have finished both paper 1 and paper 2. Okay. So what happens is if you read a concept in paper 1, you can easily link that with paper 2. And when you quote them in your answers, it becomes really holistic. Okay. So that's all. So today we've spoken about what is the, how do you write answers in anthropology? And secondly, about how to go about anthropology as a subject. So in my next video, I will be talking to you all about my book list for anthropology so that you are also able to get benefited from the same. And in case you have any queries or questions, you can also post them on the comment section below. Okay, and also do subscribe to Unacademy Plus, and you can also watch me teach live on various subjects related to civil services examination preparation. And by using my name as a referral code, you can also avail a 10% discount on your annual subscription. So thank you.